As I gear up to open up registration for my online Number Sense course, I always want to try to give some free information for all elementary teachers, whether or not you take the online course. I'm Christina Tonneveld, the recovering traditionalist, and if you have been around, you know I believe that Number Sense is one of the key missing pieces for a lot of our students. Whether it's in elementary or any grade level, teachers that I talk to, that is a piece that is always missing. So I hope that you'll stick around as we talk about building Number Sense in the upper elementary grades. I'm going to give you my top tips as we work to build our math minds so that we can build the math minds of our students. My number one tip, the thing I say all the time, Number Sense can't be taught, it's caught. Number Sense and teaching Number Sense, really, when people say, I'm going to teach Number Sense, you can't teach it. Kids have to be provided experiences. So my first top tip is provide experiences for your students. Let's say that we're working on multiplication and I want my students to learn 4 times 5. There are many of us who just learned 4 times 5 is 20. That's it. Learn it, memorize, know it. Unfortunately, for those of us who learn that way, if you were like me, we made no connections. We made no connections to other multiplication facts. We made no connections to our own real life. So the first thing I want you to do is provide experiences. So let's say we're working on multiplication. Here's a little picture of where you could, if you're doing something, you're passing out papers, you can give it as a scenario, make it into a math problem in everyday scenarios. So if each kid at your table gets 5 pieces of paper and there's 4 kids at the table, how many pieces did your table get? Now, you may have some kids who are sitting there counting one by one by one. They want to count every single piece of paper. That's where kids start. But you might also get some kids who will see some different groupings. And that's one of the powerful situations, is you have them talk about what they're noticing in that situation. But that wouldn't come out if we just gave them 4 times 5. So let's take a look at this picture again. We might have some kids who will see like splitting it in half, and they know one group of 5 and another group of 5 will give them 10, and then they can just double that. So they're starting to build this cool relationship of, man, if I'm doing 4 groups of something, that's like having 2 groups of something, and then we can double it to make the 4 groups of whatever we're needing. You might have another kid who just sees the groups of 5 and is basically skip counting by 5s. All of these are viable strategies for doing multiplication, but they may not have come out if we didn't provide experiences for kids to see the multiplication in action. So again, first top tip, provide experiences. Help your students see mathematical concepts in their everyday lives. Now, my second tip is to be providing lots of chances for kids to work with manipulatives and visuals. This is often known as the CRA continuum. It stands for concrete to representational to abstract. Oftentimes, we jump straight to the abstract, which is just symbols on a piece of paper. But for our upper grades kids, there is a lot of new stuff that they are learning. They're learning multiplication, they're learning with fractions, and they don't have the number sense yet of those numbers to really be able to jump straight into operations. So we've got to start with concrete materials. Let them physically see and feel these numbers. What does 1/3 look like, feel like? All of those things. It's not just 1/3 on a piece of paper. So you want to start out with doing things concretely. So here's an image of using fraction tiles. These are blank fraction tiles, which you can get from Hand to Mind. These are one of my favorite tools, because it does not tell you the amount that each fraction is worth. The only reason that the yellow is a fourth is because it takes four of them to fill up the red one. It's a fourth because the red is a whole. If the red wasn't the whole, then that yellow one would be worth something more. So it's really cool. It doesn't tell the kids that is a fourth. They have to figure out which one is the fourth based upon what the whole is. So then when they start to go to add fractional amounts together, and I've set it up, we've talked about it, I want them to model it. And so then they might start to put those two pieces together, and they'll put the 1/3 and the 1/4 together, but they still aren't sure how much it is. But the cool part about doing it with these tiles is they start to notice, man, that looks a little bit bigger than a half, right? Does that make sense that it would be bigger than a half? Why would it, should it be bigger than a half? So there's all this number sense that can happen just by giving them concrete materials. They're not jumping straight to the answer because they can't figure out the answer yet. They have to use the concrete manipulatives to help them because it's not there yet. And most of them can't jump straight to this thing of, let's just get common denominators. Well, why do we need common denominators? The concrete materials help us out. They start to realize, man, if I had a different size, I could maybe tell how far along in the whole it was. And they start discovering that we need to find a fractional amount that could go all the way, but using that same unit. So they got all of the same unit going across, but then they got to figure out, what do I call those units? What are the black ones called? How many of them did I use? So being able to do things concretely helps kids move along. And eventually, yes, we want to get them to the abstract of just being able to add 1/3 and 1/4 and be able to find common denominators, all of that stuff. But the concrete and the representations, the pictures that they will draw along the way, things like this, help kids understand the abstract procedure of finding common denominators and then adding those together. All right, so second tip again, start with concrete, move to having them do drawings, so doing representations, and then we move to the abstract concept of just the symbols and procedures that we're working on. All right, tip number three is to make a point of doing things daily. Develop a number sense routine every single day. So whether that is providing a real life experience for your students every single day, or whether it's having some kind of manipulative or visual every single day, you have to have this be part of your daily routine. Otherwise, it's going to go by the wayside. Textbooks assume that kids have these things and they're not built into the lessons. And so if you don't make a point of doing it, just like everything, we get wrapped up into the daily things that we got to get this done and we got to get this done. So you have to make a point of it being there every single day. So it can be woven into your math time through everyday experiences, through using manipulatives and the visuals, or you can have designated daily routines. I would encourage you to check out Jessica Shumway's book, Number Sense Routines. There is one for the upper grades that just came out recently, and it's fabulous. So there's a link below the video that will take you to her book on Amazon. So if you want to find a number sense routine, typically routines are done like separately. It's not off. Sometimes they can be part of your math time. Sometimes it's just when you have 5 or 10 minutes that you have extra in your schedule. Like if, as you're planning things out this year, if you see, man, I have this 5 minute little block right here, then pick a number sense routine. There's things like counting circles, doing a number talk. The book is full of activities and ideas that you can use to create that daily number sense routine. Now, if you want easy access to these three tips that I just gave you, click down below. There's a little cheat sheet that will give you the links and the visuals that I used in this video for you to have easy access to. Once you're kind of gone from here, we tend to forget it. Print it off, have it there on your desk somewhere where you can find it and look at it quickly. What are the ways that you can ingrain number sense into your classroom? So no matter what time of year you are watching this video, it is never too late to get started with helping your students develop their number sense. And remember, you cannot directly teach it. It is caught, not taught. So go help your students catch some number sense. And I hope that this video has helped you build your math mind so you can go build the math minds of your students. Have a great day.